We're still waiting on updates for the official schedule, although I'm not expecting anything groundbreaking outside of the fact that they may move back the Missouri State game now, because we do have a 10-game schedule, 9 conference games plus 1 non-conference, and Missouri State looks like to be it for the time being. I would assume they're going to go forward with that, but I don't expect to be played on the 29th now. But with that being said, practices have kind of come to a stop for now because they're trying to figure out what the schedule is going to be. But injuries have been piling up on the defensive side of the football. Well, offensively, you have Tanner Mordecai, who injured his hamstring. He's going to be out for an extended period. Well, we all know that Spencer Rattler was going to win this job. I think everyone, it was like, we knew he was going to be the guy. But not having your backup quarterback just in case is going to suck. Chandler Morris is going to more than likely be the guy, and behind him, you got to walk on. So you got to hope there's no injuries there, assuming we have a season. But defensively, man, Caleb Kelly goes down, as I mentioned earlier. Then you had Justin Harrington, who was our big JUCO safety prospect, who, if there was going to be a spring, he would have gone through spring, but he wasn't going to show up on time anyway. But he ends up tearing his ACL. So there's that. And at a position where we really can't afford to lose anybody. And now Marcus Hicks, playing on the outside on that front seven, he has an Achilles injury. He's out indefinitely. So this is starting to pile up, and this is not how you want to start training camp. This is not how you want to go into a season. But considering the fact the season may not even happen, I don't know. I'm gonna jokingly say I'm almost rooting for it to not happen at this point, but you still got Ronnie Perkins with the suspension deal with him, Trajan Bridges, Ramondre Stevenson. Ramondre Stevenson's like 246, according to New Height and Weights. That boy needs to cut some weight. A lot of guys got some baby fat, got some COVID fat. I think everyone in America's got a little COVID fat, but like, some of those guys, whew, it's a, some of it's good weight, some of it's bad weight, but it is what it is. But I don't know. It's to be perfectly honest, I wasn't expecting national championship this year anyway. But I still thought, okay, in a regular season before COVID, I was like, okay, we could win Big 12, maybe get into the playoff again, see what happens. But right now, it's just everything's just going nuts right now. It's hard to talk about football in general when you just don't know. It's hard to like break down. Okay, look at schedule, because nobody knows what the schedule. The only thing we know is that Michigan and Ohio State are going to allegedly play in October instead of November, and some people are losing their minds over that. And OU Texas will likely be played first week of October, as opposed to second week of October. We might play Oklahoma State early. I just want a schedule. Even if the season doesn't happen, I just want to see what it looks like. I'm dying here. I'm sure a lot of you are dying here. I don't want to talk about COVID anymore. I don't want to talk about all the crap. We've all been indoors for 5 months, a lot of us, where we can't go to movies, we can't socialize, we can't, and it's driving all of us crazy. And that's why some people are just like not, mentality-wise, they're just not putting up with it. They're going out like everything's normal, and they freak out if they're asked to wear a mask. I don't consider it a big deal because I was in the Army for 8 years, and they say if I had to wear a certain thing on my uniform, I wore it. It's like, okay, as long as I got the right equipment, right uniform, right place, right time, good to go. But man, it's just the one thing that you look forward to in the fall is just, it's teetering in front of you. It's like a car on the edge of a cliff. It hit the brakes just at the right time, but it's teetering. And if you don't move the weight all the way back, then it's going to tip over and fall into the ravine. That's it. And that's how I feel about college football right now. It sucks. And with all these injuries piling up and going up against and just it's going to be feel awful if we go into this season with the possibility of playing one or two games, and then everyone gets COVID, and then we have to put everything to a stop, and then it gets to the point where they just cancel the season. Because I think that's what's happening right now. I think we'll get one or two games in. It's like I thought, well, what was going to happen a few months ago when I said, don't expect it. We're going so far. We're on path to that, and I don't like it as much as you do. I don't want to be right. Like everyone's like, I don't want to be right here. I really don't. I would like for there to be fans in the stands to some extent. I want to see the band play the fight songs. I want to see the excitement, the passion. I want to spend my Saturdays in the fall getting up early, like 9, 10 o'clock or whatever, sleeping in, watch game day, and watch games from noon to 1 o'clock in the morning. That's what I love to do. My Saturdays are booked. You will not, unless I'm going to a game, you don't get me away from a television. Period. Unless it's an emergency or it's a life or death situation, I ain't moving. I'm going to be here. I'm going to be at a buddy's house. I might go to a big get, whatever. I'm going to be watching college football. And I thankfully have other hobbies that will keep me going, I guess, and keep me distracted, but it's not going to be the same. So I got, everyone has special things they like to do at certain parts of the year. And as of right now, it's just, you know, you got the whole deal of the Pac-12 going on right now with all their crazy demands. Outside of wanting COVID safety protocols put in, they want 50% of the revenue. They didn't think that one through. That's never going to happen. The Big Ten did theirs thing, but they want to have COVID protections. You know, they want good medical stuff going on up there. That's reasonable in this situation. It's just you got UConn canceling their season. I don't expect Rutgers to have football this year. Not at all. I think Rutgers is going to be the first, and then everyone's going to freak out at the Big Ten. They got 14 teams that they can deal with. Florida's a hot spot. Louisville is like losing their minds with all the COVID stuff. It's just, as soon as you interact with another college program, I don't know. I don't know how this is going to work out at the end of the day. I'm not optimistic right now. I mean, it's like, you know, as great a job as OU football has done in dealing with the COVID thing, that's just one team. They can't play each other forever. It doesn't matter. Whole point is to compete with other teams and see how well you do, and we're probably not going to get that. And, you know, like, what I'm probably going to end up doing at the end of the day is, if there is no season, I've been working on this project. I've had to put it to the side here and there just to focus on making money and, you know, not starving to death, because, you know, that happens. Because I had a couple gigs lined up, but COVID put the kibosh on that. So I have an idea. I've mentioned it in my Twitter feed. I probably mentioned it before. I'm working on a top 25 OU football moment series. If football's not going to happen, that's probably going to be my focus. I'm going to work on that. And that will be your OU football content for the season if there is no football. So, these aren't going to be like me in front of a camera. Well, maybe a little bit, but I'm going to put a little production to this and see what I can come up with. But with that being said, injuries suck. Got to deal with them. And just keeping fingers crossed here. Listen, at the end of the day, I think they're going to attempt the season. I really do. But at this point, I don't expect it on the 29th. I expect it more September 5th or 12th or September 5th or 12th, whenever they can get going. Because they want to have this Missouri State game a couple weeks before the Big 12 season. And a lot of people say, oh, this is for built-in bye weeks. It's for just in case for COVID. I mean, yeah, you get the benefit of bye weeks for injuries, but man, with COVID, it's like you need that couple weeks in case some guy tests positive, and you got to like make sure he can, you know, recover and be all right. But anyway, I'm rambling at this point. I've been overdue for a rambling video. But that being said, Boomer Sooner, and knock on wood, and keep hoping.